Good Miniature Monday, friends. Rodge here, aka the Wisco Horn Dog. Hope your Monday is off to a fantastic start. Take a look at these sweet ass Stranger Things themed models I recently created. So if you've seen the Netflix show Stranger Things, you probably recognize both of these figures here. If you haven't seen it, I'm not really interested in explaining it to you, but it's a pretty awesome 80s theme, kind of sci-fi horror Goonies type feel to it. It's pretty awesome, definitely worth checking out. And so after watching the show, I was interested in picking up the Demogorgon model, which was so prominently featured. I did a little research and I found out Muralton Miniatures in Italy actually picked up the rights for all these models from the 70s and 80s, all these old D&D companies. And they're still cranking those babies out. It was 10 euros, well, that would be 15. I think they had a minimum for shipping. So it ended up being 25 or 30 bucks, I think, in the end. And actually, I looked on eBay at the time, funny story, and the things were gone for 75 or 100 bucks, which was pretty bananas. People were just, if they had them, they were cashing them out for that sweet Demogorgon cash. I looked just now, and there's a buy it now for 25 bucks. So it looks like the prices have come down to something more reasonable. So I picked that model up. I didn't really have any purpose for it. I just thought it was cool to have the actual model from the show, kind of a fun little display piece. But I was actually inspired by a post I saw on a Infinity Facebook group where somebody posted the HVT model that they had created. And HVT model, just real quick, if you're not aware of Infinity stuff, it's a just like a little objective model that is a little fun piece that you can make. You can use anything you want. It's common not to actually like use, you know, official Infinity models. You can just use little superhero miniatures or whatever fun stuff you want. And somebody had done up the little kid from Akira in a little smock and stuff like that. So I thought that was really cool. And then I'm like, that'd be cool if I had a 11 version. She's like the more modern version of that. So I'm like, oh, that'd be cool. And then I could actually, it'd be fun to use both of them, just kind of have them both and you'd just be able to flip-flop between them, but put them on a display board or just show them off or just have them together. I thought it was really cool. So that was a little trickier proposition in getting a 11 model because there isn't actually, nobody makes one, but I was able to find the basis for a model, which actually looked pretty close. So this ended up being hassle-free miniatures. There's actually not too many places that sculpt little kid models or anything like that, but this is the closest kind of match I could find. And you can see it looks pretty good because she has the jacket and then the dress and the shoes kind of match. The head obviously is totally off. Unfortunately, I looked around. I didn't really find a suitable kid's head that I could use. So I just thought to myself, well, sure, I'll just make one from scratch. I'm pretty good with green stuff. And, well, that is exactly what I did. It took a long time to do that. I've never sculpted a human face before. I have sculpted a model from scratch, but it was this weird frog dude. But doing a human face and like a kid size one where it's even smaller than normal, that was pretty brutal. It took a long time to just add a little layer, one little layer at a time, like a little eye hole and another little eye hole, build up a cheek, build up another cheek, add a nose. And for my first attempt, I think it turned out pretty well. Like if you were going to sculpt one, yeah, have a professional sculptor do one. I don't think it would turn out that much better than this one that I did. But as you can see, it looked pretty good in the end. And as far as painting goes, I basically for 11, I just copied this particular photo. It was kind of my reference point. So, basically just copying from the show itself. The Demogorgon model, that was a little different beast. So in the actual show, the painted version that they have on the tabletop is, it's kind of, it looks like it's dipped almost. It's kind of got like a gloss wash to it. It looks like it's kind of whitish, and then it has like a dark head and then red eyes and like a white horn. And then the actual creature on the show is, I don't know, you can't really get a good look at it, hardly ever. And the still images don't really give you that much detail either. It's just kind of brownish and kind of glossy. So I wanted it more to represent the actual kind of creature from the show, because I was going to put it on the tabletop and kind of use it for that. So that's kind of what I went with, kind of split the difference almost. But he's kind of greenish a little bit in his, I guess, furry areas. I don't know, the model itself is kind of weird. It's kind of classic 80s model, just with the thickness of it. It's just like, well, we're not gonna make a multi-piece here. It's just gonna be one piece. But the texture on it's weird. It's like furry but bumpy. I don't know if it's supposed to be like a reptile scales or whatever. I kind of thought of him as that way rather than fur. And then I kind of use a slightly different tone for his belly pieces. And then his fur got something else. And then I used the same kind of purples for the highlights that I mixed in for his horn. Did the red eyes just like the one in the show. So I think they turned out pretty good, pretty fun. So I'm going to be taking these with me to Twinfinity. So you normally only need one HVT model. And this will be fun because I'll basically offer my opponent to use one of them so we could both use them and kind of have a weird kind of like subplot going on here, a Stranger Things subplot with, you know, there are objectives related to these pieces, and you can always capture the HVT. So it'll be fun if somebody takes me up on that offer. During the games, I'll probably just use the 11 one because it's so small. So hope you enjoyed taking a look at those. It was really fun. So they were actually, the 11 was done. I took her to Adepticon. I haven't posted any photos until now. The actual Demogorgon was just painted within the last week. So it basically was finished. I did have it a three color minimum for the paint challenge stuff I was doing last year, but just recently completed. So enjoy these photos and videos. Maybe I'll do some other ones about it too, but I think that is about it for this week's topic, and we're gonna check out the hobby desk now. So my challenge for myself last week was to finish the basing on the last few Infinity models that I recently painted, and I did do so. Check out the Tech B here, looking fancy with that nice base. The Red Friar got a base as well, and then Rinsho, the Bushido model, I finished him as well, his base. So those guys turned out great. The second thing I was going to do was actually work on a bucket load of Infinity terrain for Twinfinity that I was bringing to help out the TO Sean. But early last week, I received an email from him. It was sent to all the people who are bringing terrain, and he said that he was getting 10 tables worth of terrain donated by Muzon Minis, which is pretty freaking awesome. But due to that, some of the people who were bringing a bunch of terrain, you know, if he's got all these extra tables, he doesn't need people to bring as much stuff. So my commitment went from 6 tables down to 3, which is, last week I mentioned I had about 5.5 tables worth of terrain done. So that basically was pretty awesome. You can tell I am a procrastinator, because even though this stuff needs to get done, I need to kind of spruce it up for Wapaka, which is months and months away. You know, so it needs to get done, and I set us the time aside to do it. But then once I heard that Sean wasn't going to need the terrain, I basically stopped immediately and was like, whoo, free, I'm free and clear. So that is a classic procrastinator move. If you ever found yourself doing something similar, you are definitely a procrastinator like myself. So I kind of took it easy and I thought that I was pretty much in the clear, but it actually took a couple days before I remembered that I had to do the freaking display board. So I recently hit up Michael's, got a big nice oval, which is going to be the basis for it. I'm going to add some pieces of terrain in the back and do something nice for the Yellow Jackets because they're pretty much finished. So after this week, I'm going to have that display board done, but it should be kind of interesting. It's going to be the start of a bunch of new projects because I'm basically everything I have is painted right now, so I'm all caught up. So I got to figure out what I want to do going forward. I'm going to be purchasing some new items, so I'm probably going to be talking about that stuff maybe next week, maybe the week after. So my goal for next week is to start and finish that display board. I guess it needs to be done before Monday. It's got to be Friday when I head down there, so hopefully 4 weeknights is enough to do that. If you want to set a challenge for yourself this week, go ahead, post below if you can finish it and post some pics. I will share your success with all the people following along. And if you're enjoying these videos, please share with a friend. I really appreciate that. I also appreciate those who subscribed and shared already. And just keep on hobby horn dogging, and I'm going to catch you guys next week.